This is the Sports Hit List by the fans for the fans.
Carl Coulange for the Sports Hit List by the fans and for the fans. Today we are here to discuss the best of Survivor Series. It's Thanksgiving time. We like to give thanks. We give thanks for Survivor Series. This is the November pay-per-view for WWE, one of the core four pay-per-views that they have. Let me introduce my panel. The Outlaw, Mr. Zach Droll. How you doing, sir?
Doing very good. Very, very good. I am here. Also, guys, check out AEW Injection every Thursday on the Sports Hit List.
Thank you so much for you and Nick for putting that together. We need to give more props to AEW. I've been watching a little bit more. They've been doing some good work. I love the promos. Excellent work on their part. We have the analyst, Mr. Mike Murillo. Mike, how you doing, man?
Change my name, okay?
So what do you want to be called?
The Assassin.
The Assassin. Right. Okay, that's the Assassin.
The only reason you guys called me that was because when Zach made the graphics for me, the Assassin couldn't fit in.
All right, so we'll go with the Assassin. We have JJ Louis and Randy Louis, both from the Backstage Brawl, my brothers. Thank you, guys. How you doing?
Oh, we good, man. We good. We just started going live now on Instagram. So those shows have been going good, and we got some good stuff coming in the future.
Absolutely,
so,
for sure. JJ, how's it going, man?
Doing good. We just finished up recording and editing this new show we like to call Bell to Bell. It's aside from our regular weekly podcast, so hope y'all stay tuned for that one. That's going to be special.
For sure, man. You guys keep doing the work. And again, thank you for always sharing and supporting the Sports Hit List content and brand. So today we are here to talk about Survivor Series, one of the core four pay-per-views. We have Royal Rumble, WrestleMania, SummerSlam, and Survivor Series. So what are your guys, when I say Survivor Series, let me start with you, Zach. What's your favorite moment from Survivor Series?
I'm going to kind of go with like last year's when it was like every single like branch in WWE. You had Raw, SmackDown, and NXT just all colliding. And when like even after like we had this the Saudi show incident, and then everyone stormed the ring from NXT, and that solidified what we were going to get. So like just the brand warfare from every side was
okay.
My favorite.
What did you guys think of that? That was pretty cool last year. It was the first time we saw that, you know, Triple H showed up with Shawn Michaels and they decided to invade Raw and SmackDown. What did you guys think of that?
It was a blessing. It was a blessing in disguise because, like, you know, they had that whole Saudi trip that went terribly. And I think that for all the crap that we give WWE, they're basically A1 when it comes to, like, crisis plans, like breaking out that emergency staff and just basically hammering home something. So SmackDown had nobody come through. They had NXT come through that one night. Adam Cole became a star overnight, that he was already a star in NXT, but you know, in terms of all brands, and then NXT, as you saw, Survivor Series. So that SmackDown leading into that month of November that finished off a Survivor Series, that was fantastic.
Randy, when I say Survivor Series, what comes to mind? What's your favorite moment from the pay-per-view?
2001. That's probably one of my favorite matches. Of course, the Survivor Series classic matchup between Team Alliance and Team WWF. You know, what's not to love? And one of the rare times I saw The Rock get a pin on Stone Cold Steve Austin, with thanks to Kurt Angle, but still, it was one of my favorite.
It's
my favorite Survivor Series moments of all time.
Yeah, I actually have to second that. You just reminded me. That's a good one. I think that's one of my favorite ones of all time. Just the fact that I was as a teenager watching that, I was kind of nervous if WWF at the time was going to lose, and I'm like, oh my god, they may actually lose this. And yeah, I think Vince had and I think if you go back, Vince probably had one of the best pep talks ever. Like he had Chris Jericho, Big Show, Undertaker, Kane, and The Rock, is just dancing the whole time through the whole promo, and Vince is just like, go out there and just do it. And then they all just walked out and they ended up winning it. I thought it was great. Like, and then Vince just walks out with his hands in the air and they end up winning the pay-per-view and beating the Alliance. And Kurt Angle ends up hitting, I think, Austin with the championship to give WWE the win.
Or that's Chris Jericho. I don't remember, but it was
Chris Jericho
turned on WWE.
On the Rock. Yeah. Chris Jericho turned on The Rock that night because they were beefing. And then Vince even said, he said, someone from the Alliance is going to turn, and it ended up being Kurt Angle. That was a good one. Mike, when I say Survivor Series, what comes to mind?
I love the brand supremacy, but I love the one that they did back in 2005. That was just so awesome. When you had SmackDown, you had Batista, Rey Mysterio, JBL. I mean, you had and you had a prime Bobby Lashley, and then you went up against the Raw team, and the Raw team was kind of weak because you had Chris Masters and Carlito in that team. Like, come on. But it's just the buildup was so cool. Like, you had Batista always getting his ass kicked by The Undertaker and Kane. But then every once in a while, you would have Batista just come into the ring and just completely smash everybody in his way. I love that version of Batista, and it really came out at Survivor Series that year. And not to mention Randy Orton, who was in a storyline with The Undertaker. The Undertaker comes back on that night. So it's pretty cool.
Is that the one where the casket opens with the fire?
You get the sweet tight camera shot of Randy Orton just like, oh shit, let me down.
Because he was celebrating. I remember that one. That was a good one. Cool. Good moment. JJ, when I say Survivor Series, what do you think of?
Oh, can you know, I just do one more thing? Can I just get one more thing in there? It's also pretty bittersweet because that was the night Eddie Guerrero was supposed to be on the SmackDown Survivor Series team. He had passed away 2 weeks prior to Survivor Series.
Yeah.
So that it also makes it memorable and kind of a spooky way when you think about it, because he was supposed to be there. So I want to bring that up too, because that's another thing that made it pretty memorable.
And
rest in peace to Eddie, man.
That's a
go ahead, JJ.
For all intents and purposes, you took the word out of my mouth, you know, like in terms of brand supremacy, I think of that SmackDown versus Raw era, you know what I mean? When the video games was popping, you know, Ruthless Aggression was on and popping, and like the basically the biggest one of the bunch arguably was in fact 2005. But you like, I mean, what's there been said that hasn't already been said about that? But I would say, like, in terms of the first thing that comes to mind for me beside that is just the fact that the storylines that you work in between the Survivor Series thing, the last thing people think about, the Shawn Michaels, the Randy Ortons of the world, those Iron Men within those like matches where it's like they go one on two and you could see the story within the story. Dolph Ziggler in 2014, I think that's another one where it was just like, yo, is this his time? Like, I can't believe this is happening. And like when basically he's going 1v2, and he's like, all right, it's going to be same old, same old. And then he rises up from the ashes. Sting pops out at the end, and then he gets the pin over Seth Rollins. So when I think Survivor Series, I think those stories, those underdog stories coming true, and also the debuts.
Yes. Well, thank you for transition. This is why we have so much great chemistry, JJ. That was my next point was so many stars debuts are iconic moments. I think you guys highlighted, but for me, there's so many moments of history, and you guys know we are all wrestling enthusiasts and we're like walking encyclopedias. Undertaker debuts in 1990. You had The Rock debuted in 1996. You had 1999, Stone Cold gets hit by the car and you're like, oh my God, is he really hurt? Like what happened? And then Big Show comes in and wins the match. You know,
you have 2011 with the Rock and Cena, never before and never again.
Yeah, and then they faced The Miz and R-Truth, right? With Little Jimmy, yeah. So
Zack Ryder stole the show, though, and he wasn't even a part of the match.
Yeah, so I think there have been moments in Survivor Series history that people tend to forget, but they still exist and they're still there. Especially even with the traditional Survivor Series elimination matches, I look forward to, you know, just the 5-on-5, like, you know, maybe a 5-against-1 or 5-against-2. Those are always interesting to see. And for me, Survivor Series definitely does hold a special place. But as JJ alluded to, those are iconic debuts of, you know, and certain things that do happen among Survivor Series are great. Or even when The Rock became corporate Rock, it was at Survivor Series.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? He did his heel turn. He did his heel turn, like his major heel turn again as corporate Rock. And I think it was 1998 Survivor Series, you know? So I think going into this year's, it's kind of disappointing that Undertaker's going out and he can't get the Undertaker chance. Like, he should get his flowers. In the words of Ray Jarvis, but it's disappointing that, you know, we'll be chanting at home and you won't actually hear us there to give him a proper send-off.